Our lecturer tonight is Mr. Robert Peterson, who is a native of Wisconsin, holds a BA degree from Lawrence College and a master's degree from the University of Wisconsin. After leaving school, he served 3 years in the armed forces, then returning to Lawrence College, accepted a position as assistant to the president. Mr. Peterson subsequently served as public information officer on board the hospital ship Hope during its first voyage to Indonesia in 1961. He returned to Indonesia in 1962 as public relations and sales manager of Hotel Indonesia in Jakarta. Mr. Peterson's most recent location has been Rio de Janeiro, where he has lived for the past 2 years. Mr. Peterson is at present residing in Baltimore, Maryland, where he will begin work on a PhD in history. His lecture tonight is titled Brazilia. Mr. Peterson.
Stephen's Cathedral in Vienna are rung only on the occasion of events of international significance. On April 21st, 1960, the cathedral bells were rung. And at the same time, 400 miles away in Milan, Italy, a flock of 100 white doves was released. And in almost every major capital in the world, telegrams of congratulations went out over the wires. The event was the opening of the city of Brasilia, the new capital of Brazil and the largest planned city on Earth. In the past 4,000 years of recorded human history, there have been only 13 instances of a country building a capital from nothing, leveling off a piece of land and putting a planned capital on it. The last time it happened in our hemisphere was our own Washington, D.C., of course. But not since 1360 B.C., when the Egyptian pharaoh, Amenhotep IV, built the city of Akhenaten in central Egypt, has a country built a planned capital far removed from the settled areas of its territory, leveled off a piece of land in the wilderness, and put a planned capital on it. This has happened again in the case of Brasilia, and tonight I'd like to take you on a very brief trip to Brasilia, show you something of what this rather unusual city looks like, and tell you something about the country that is building it. So if we may have lights out, we can start the pictures. There. Could you move the span just a bit to the right? I think I didn't get it quite lined up there. Yeah, that's thank you very much. This is Brasilia, the capital of the fourth largest country in the world and seat of government for 80 million people, the construction of which ranks among the dramatic and imaginative undertakings of mankind in this century. Brasilia was opened only 3.5 years after construction was begun, and it's located in the midst of 60,000 square miles of wilderness in the interior of Brazil. One of the most striking aspects of Brasilia is the vastness of scale on which the city is built, and the even vaster setting in which the city is placed. Visitors walking across the Plaza of the Three Powers here toward the Ministry of Justice in the distance are sometimes surprised when they reach these statues in the city square to find that human figures come up only to the knees of the two statues. And it's rather difficult when you're standing out here looking at these ministry buildings scattered about like so many children's building blocks to realize that each one is actually 10 stories tall. And the rather overpowering 28-story Congress building, which looks so immense close up, you can get an idea of scale by the human figure standing in front of the dome on the left over there. The Senate meets in that dome, and the Chamber of Deputies, or the House of Representatives, meets in the bowl on the right. The building, which looks so immense close up, shrinks into almost perfect miniature a mile away. And at the outskirts of the city, this whole 12-building complex here is almost completely swept up in the vastness of the plain on which the city is set. Which reminds one again, really, that Brasilia is a frontier city set out in the midst of the uninhabited interior for the purpose of bringing settlers and immigrants into the empty interior of the country. The story of Brasilia starts really quite some time ago with the discovery of Brazil itself. Brazil is perhaps unique in the world in having its boundaries drawn before it was discovered. Pope Alexander VI had become so tired over the eternal bickering between the Spanish and the Portuguese over who was going to control the world that he got them together in 1494 at Tordesillas, where a line was drawn down a map of the world, dividing it into two parts. The Spanish were to have claim to all the non-Christian lands to the left of the line, and the Portuguese were to have claim to all the non-Christian lands to the right of the line. When South America was later discovered, the line ran through it, and Portugal was able to claim the part that stuck out to the right, which became Brazil. As soon as the Portuguese had established a colony in Brazil in the mid-1500s, they began to cast about for a place to build a capital. They decided at once the capital should be built as far from the seacoast as possible, where it would be safe from the marauding Dutch and French fleets. Until they could locate a suitable spot for the capital, however, they established it temporarily at the seaport of Bahia. Well, temporarily lasted for 250 years. And when gold was later discovered further south in 1763, they moved the capital down there to another seaport named Rio de Janeiro, and there it stayed permanently. There still was a great deal of talk about moving the capital inland, however. The capital in the interior was named Brasilia, the name it bears today, in 1570. The federal district was laid out in 1824, and the Constitution of 1792, the Constitution of 1811, the Constitution of 1835, and the Constitution of 1874 all said that the capital must be moved into the interior without delay. Nothing happened. A city was built in the interior at this time, really at the end of it,